the priceless part is all the no's you ran into, all the failures that happened, all the slip-ups, you know, all the times you got knocked down. That is the fun part of the story.
Life collapse on you and catch you on the blind side. It drop you to your knees and start choking you. What reason can you remember that you can call on, that you can reach on, that can make you get back up?
I just remember feeling this tremendous shame. And at some point, I think we all hit that moment in life where things just are not going how you thought they would go.
Find that reason. Because when life had knocked me down, I said, life, I'm doing this because I want to make my mama proud of me. I'm doing this because I want my children to have a better life than what I have. I'm doing this because all my life I've been told I'd be a loser, that I wouldn't make it.
See, if you're always winning, then you don't really understand what it is to win. You got to take those losses. You got to take those hits. There's got to be the valleys, the peaks, the ups, the downs. In order for you to, when it does happen, you go, wow, bueno, qué rico. You know, this is what it's all about. And not only that, it's never about making it, guys. It's always about maintaining it. That's the toughest part.
The second restaurant failed, and they held on to it for too long. So by the time that they closed the second restaurant, it was an $800,000 loss. I get just choked up just thinking about how terrifying it was. And so I found myself at the age of 41, like, just feeling like a complete failure.
You're down that path, and all you're seeing is rejection and adversity and demise. How do you continue that path when the monkey on your back feels like a 500-pound gorilla weighing you down? How do you put one foot in front of the other, continue the journey in that endeavor of life and cross that finish line?
It's hard. When you're working on something and you put everything you have in it, and it doesn't work out, you lose your money and other people's money.
There's no losing, only learning. There's no failure, only opportunities. And there's no problems, only solutions. So to me, what failure is the mother of all success. If it wasn't for Michael Jordan getting cut from his ninth grade basketball team, he wouldn't have became Michael Jordan.
It's hard living. Life is hard. See, it's hard when you are 49 years old, been working on a job for 17 years, and they come in and tell you you're finished and give you 1 week severance pay. It's hard handling just the tragedies of life.
At some point, we all bought into this lie that you've got to feel ready in order to change.
Yeah.
We bought into this complete falsehood that at some point, you're going to have the courage. At some point, you're going to have the confidence. And it's total bull. It's complete garbage.
So to anybody here that feels that they left losing something, no, all you did was gain. And not only did you gain, understand, they say that be wise is to know what you don't know. So therefore, coming here and not knowing certain things that maybe didn't lead you to the prize, but in the grand scheme of things, 10 years from now, God knows what the grand prize may be, 3 to 5 years from now.
You will go through things, and while you're going through them, you can't understand why it's happening to you. But after you go through it, you get back and you look at it and you say, oh, now I understand why I needed that lesson. I couldn't understand it then, but after I got through it, then I saw that that was preparing me for bigger and better things.
There is a blessing in everything. Behind every moment of adversity in your life, there is a blessing and a lesson. Every moment of adversity has those two things. Pain always leaves a gift.
You focus on negative so much, you start to believe that negative exists in you. That's a negative, unhealthy diet.
You cannot erase the work ethic part. Ain't no elevator to the top. You got to take the stands. The elevator don't go to the top, man. Not in the world of success. You got to take the stand.
Right now in society, we're living in a society that they actually believe that perfection exists, which, by the way, it doesn't. So therefore, it's a perfect time, perfect message to let everybody know that perfect doesn't exist.
You have to live your life with the expectation that great things are coming your way.
During those hard times, we didn't know how you're going to make payroll. During those times when you fail and things didn't work out, they were nowhere to be found. See, when it's hard, there's a struggle. See, what you become in the process is more important than
you. I don't take anything for granted. Appreciate every opportunity, and more than anything, enjoy the ride. Right. Life is short.